Hey, what's up, y'all? We're back with another one. There was a helicopter who crashed into a building in Manhattan today. And you know how they were trying to check the alcohol levels and drug to make sure, you know, he wasn't high as a kite when he was driving it, like that nigga on a Denzel movie. And they also wanted to make sure that it wasn't a terrorist threat. So I can understand that. But I was thinking of something too. This might be weird, but at the same time as this happening, another video came out about building a wall in New York for the sea levels. Now, that makes more sense than Trump building a wall to keep illegal immigrants out. But I mean, in a sense, now that I think about it, if they're illegal, they shouldn't be over here anyway. Only legal people, right? But hey, what do I know? But listen to this. Check this out.
National correspondent Jerika Duncan joins us. She is near the scene. Jerika, we're hearing that there may be a press conference soon. Are you hearing the same?
We understand that to be true. I was just inside the Manhattan Times Square Hotel where I just walked by, saw Mayor Bill de Blasio go in with several other officials. I imagine they are getting briefed at this time so that they can then give a news conference. But just to give you a different vantage point, we're here closer to 52nd and 7th, and they just set up these barricades here to sort of keep us away from this building. As Meg Oliver mentioned, over 50 floors. And when you look up to the sky, you can't tell whether you're seeing a little bit of smoke at times, or if it's just the fog, especially when we just got here, now looking more like fog. But there are so many questions about what was this person doing flying at this particular time. When you look at the conditions, it's rainy, it's foggy, it's hard to see, but it's our understanding again that there was some sort of distress call. So he knew that he was in need of help and I guess landed here on this building. But right now, it is extremely hard to get a full vantage point. When we first got here, we were sort of walking around through and asking people what they heard, what they saw, what they witnessed. And many people said the same thing. You know, you look up and you don't see much but fog. And even reports of people who were further away and in some of these higher buildings and also couldn't see exactly what happened. So we're standing by waiting for more information. As I just said to you, within the last 15 minutes, Mayor Bill de Blasio walking into the Times Square Manhattan Hotel with a number of other officials who are likely getting briefed at this hour. We're hoping, of course, to learn more information as we get it, but it appears, as we've reported on our local station and then now here, that there is one fatality.
Andrea, do you get the sense that more buildings are continuing to be evacuated or that they have stopped evacuating buildings and the scene has stopped growing at this point?
I'm going to see if Fred can bring his camera a little bit closer just to give you another vantage point. So there's a Sheraton here, a Sheraton, New York. You see a bunch of people outside of that hotel. My understanding is they are still evacuating some of these buildings, at least nearby, because we're not sure, you know, in terms of the structure, if there are any concerns. And the Sheraton, if you kind of look up, Fred, if you go up, you can see it's basically right next to the building where this helicopter apparently landed. So, you know, it's FDNY, it's NYPD. They're going to take extra precaution when it comes to this type of stuff that you just heard with Governor Cuomo talking about some of the events, obviously, with 9/11 that have taken place. This is something that they take very seriously. We're hearing people right now saying, let's go, let's go. So I'm not sure if they're asking us to move. I'm just trying to get a better sense of what's going on. But it is our understanding that people were being evacuated. I know people in this hotel were also being told to come downstairs in the lobby. Some folks said that they were told they couldn't go back to their rooms at this hour. The hotel being across the street from the building, that is a concern. So it looks like we're being moved back. Tanya, I'm going to send it back into you, but I'm not exactly sure what's going on right now.
All right, Jerika Duncan, thank you so much for that, as you can see there.
In 2012, Superstorm Sandy pummeled the east coast of America. Winds blew in at 80 miles per hour, and heavy rain pushed the ocean over 9 feet above average levels. In New York, storm surges brought 30-foot waves ashore, flooding streets, subways, and homes. 20 miles south of Manhattan, several neighborhoods on the small borough of Staten Island sat in ruins. Homes were completely leveled, and 24 people were killed. research has shown that increasingly violent storms will likely continue assaulting our coast. Paired with rising sea levels, that could mean higher risk of flooding and worsening catastrophic damage to areas like this, unless we learn to adapt. And for Staten Island, that means building a wall.
Adaptation is this idea that we are physically remaking our cities to make sure that they are going to be resilient in the climate disasters of the future. And that will also include retrofitting our cities for the everyday effects of climate change, which means things like extreme heat, heavy downpours, drought.
A seawall is one of these adaptations. It's erected parallel to the coast to create a hard shoreline. It deflects daily tides to keep the shore from eroding away as it would under normal conditions. If a natural disaster strikes, it's meant to stop incoming storm surges or even a tsunami. Now, if fortifying our cities with walls seems too simple and a bit medieval,